So today we are going over the new patch notes, which has dropped in the PDS, and most of the stuff is regarding the Greymoor chapter. Okay, let's see. Welcome, blah blah blah. Yeah, interesting. Greymoor. Nice. Okay. Oh, that's indeed a lot of stuff there. Okay, new zone. Yeah, those are details about the PTS. Oh, antiquities. Actually, I'm interested in the antiquity system. Okay, new antiquity system allows you to score. Okay, that's what I know. Okay, antiquarian circles, I assume this is something like a new guild or something, right? In most cases, before you can scry, you need to obtain a lead. Leads can be found by a variety of ways. Oh, not require you to be an antiquarian to obtain them. So basically people without the DLC can obtain them. Okay. Wait, some leads may require you to have explore a zone completing a quest. Okay, I explored all zones in the game. I have done every quest in the game. Does this mean when I log into Greymoor I'm just spammed with hundreds of those leads, or because I basically cleared the whole game? Okay, some leads are known to someone else. Okay, so they are like random drops or something. Okay, so it's a mini game basically, right? You need the guild, then you can do the mini game. Okay, the mythic items, that's interesting. I mean, I know those already, but I didn't see the values yet. Oh, those sneaky guys! Do you see this? Requires Osinium, requires Murkmire, requires Somerset. Okay, that's the Zenimax I know. Buying Greymoor. Yeah, buying Greymoor isn't enough. Of course, you need ASO Plus or the DLCs. Okay. That's really so Zenimax, what the heck. Do they later show the values for the sets? Or I assume so, right? In the set section, probably. Okay. Dwarven Ebonwolf mount, 17 fragments, okay. Okay, this guy looks like a lot of work, right? Okay, it's like a map system. Three new motors, okay. Yeah, body mocks, nobody cares. New music box, oh. Sounds stupid, but I'm a music box collector, so gonna get this. Ah, sneaky again, sneaky. Requires chief skill, okay. Requires Somerset. They just can't keep their fingers from that, right? Yeah, probably. I mean, it sounds like you get those random leads and maps and you do this thing and then you get a random drop, right? So it's a grind, basically. New trial, okay. Yeah, gonna not go over the trial yet, but probably when Greymoor is released, I will jump into the normal version at least and see how it goes. Okay, new item sets. There we go. Number of new sets you can obtain through various means, either from the Overland, new trial, crafting, and a new antiquity system, as always. Okay, Overland, Windows Respite, Light Armor. Recovery, maximum magicka. Casting abilities that leave an effect on the ground will create a circle of healing frost for 10 seconds. You and your allies restore. Wait, so it's basically 10 seconds. That's 23k health, right? Yeah. I mean, is it good for a small scale? Maybe if you make your stand inside the building or something and then you just stay anyway and wait for the people to come in? not sure if it's good for a healer there, right? Maybe. I mean, you get a lot of resources. Not worth it? Okay. Venomous Bite. Weapon critical, critical, weapon damage, dealing damage, inflicts 100 venom on the enemy. Wait. Okay, I'm not sure. Critical damage, is it that... It's not really that good in PvP, right? Or, I mean, you usually want weapon damage because it also buffs your heals and stuff, or max stamina or something. I mean, it seems more like this is for trash fights in PvE or something, right? Because it spreads and you have critical, so... Yeah, not really convinced by this set. Eternal Vigor, okay. Magicka, stamina recovery... Wait, 300... Oh, that's like... isn't there already a Tri-Stat recovery set? Oh, I forgot the name, but there was already a set, right? No, not Ember Blasm. Oh, I forgot the name. There was one set which gives you also a... But I think the 5-piece effect was just a flat recovery for everything. Yeah. Yeah, but only for recovery. I don't like it. Don't like it, really. Stuns favor. Weapon damage, spell damage, physical, spell, weapon, spell, increases... Oh. Wait, 13? What? No. This is a error, right? What the fuck? Oh, sorry, I forget this goes on YouTube. So you get double damage, double penetrate. Okay, cut this out, but you get the idea, right? Yeah, what the heck? 13, so basically... But wait, isn't there a penetration cap in the game? Pretty sure there's a pen cap, right? But still, what the heck? I mean, that's one way to make people not using Onslaught anymore, right? So, okay, that's an Onslaught nerf, nobody slots Onslaught. What the fuck? Okay, that's... Okay, this set, gonna keep an eye on this. Dragon's Appetite, weapon damage, recovery, recovery. I'm not a fan of double recovery. Okay, so this is like a werewolf set, right? Or maybe you combine it with Deadly Strike or something. Yeah, but this sounds a lot like a werewolf set, right? Yeah, deadly strike and stuff. But I mean, werewolf inflicts bleed damage, right, with his light attacks. And of course, for werewolf, he gets a shit ton of recovery, so it may not even be that bad. His spell parasite, spell damage. Oh, spell critical. Okay, so this is aimed at PvE, right? I mean, I would like this... Yeah... Restore. But it's like, what, 120... 240 recovery per second, basically, right? I mean, if this was like, let's say, spell penetration or magicka recovery, maybe it would be good, but... Sounds like a poor man's lich set, right? Just you can't one-bar this, you have to double-bar it. Yeah, not a big fan. Okay, let's go over the trial set. Spell pen, blah blah blah, damage, healing. Oh, now we know why they pushed the light attack change, right? Dealing damage with fully charged. And he has to be off balance. Yeah, this sucks, right? I mean, you can get your Major Slayer hours rise, right? Not a big fan. Nah, not a big fan. This critical damage grants a stack of... Okay, so that's like 1500 damage, weapon damage. I mean, it could be good if people have trouble with resources, right? Yeah, but for the trial sets, gonna see out if they really outperform the existing sets, right? I mean, there I'm not the one to judge, right? So I check out what the people on who are doing actual trials come up with. Okay, Magicka Recover. Okay, so this is the healing set. Casting an ability. Okay, so you have only 40% uptime, right? I mean, it's good, right? 11 people. Yeah, but... Yeah, not really convinced. This is the tank set. Yeah, nah, I can't judge the trial sets. I'm not really a fan, right? So... Okay. Mythics, okay. Bloodborns, Bloodlord's Embrace, Heavy Chest. What? I can only have one. Wait. Dealing a bash attack, place a persistence, uncleansable. Okay, so Templars and Necros can't get rid of it, okay? You have one blood cursed enemy at a time and dealing additional moves the blood course means if you bash a different target, the different target has the blood course. And whenever... Okay. One thing I don't see here is a cooldown. It can't be cleansed and it doesn't naturally run out. So when you 1v1 someone, you have constantly this effect up by just bashing once, right? Am I getting this right or am I wrong here? Right? It doesn't run out basically. So I get every time in a duel I get 685 per second. Yeah, or that. Or permablock with ice staff for example. I mean when you don't I have to check out the impact change, right? But if you're actually able to run sturdy. You run sturdy, you run ice staff and you run this set, right? I mean Cinemax. It doesn't run out, that's stupid, okay. I see potential for cheese builds here, really. Yeah, it's a one piece, obviously you need to fit it in somewhere, right? Okay, Tarrasian Stranglers. Killing an enemy grants you a stack of Swords Call. To 20. Okay. Wait a second. Yeah, 3k is... What? And it doesn't run out, right? As long as you wear the set, it doesn't say... Does it say that it gets removed if you die? No, right? Yeah, 40% more damage taken, right? It's true, but... probably need to test this in PTS if it also runs out when you die, right? Because the only condition is you deselect the set you're crouching or you're going invisible, right? It doesn't say anything about being removed upon death or something. But I would assume if you die, you lose the buff, right? Otherwise, yeah. I mean, it has its niche, right? And killing an enemy, right? So this means... I know, I was thinking about bombing, right? But if you use this on a bomber, you can't go invisible, right? So it's not useful. Otherwise, you could just kill NPCs, get the 20 stacks and then bomb, right? But it says you can't go... Yeah, PvE and PvP mobs especially, yeah. I mean, you have ways to charge it, right? But for bombing, it's useless because you can't go invisible, right? I mean, otherwise it would be a pierce. Fuck, yeah. I mean, gotta see how much the... 40 damage is quite a lot, right? But on the other hand, when you get spell damage, your healers are also buffed, so... Gonna have to see this in action. I see some potential here, definitely. Snow tree, there's medium field. You are immune to snare that can be cleansed. What the heck? Okay, you can't be snared, but you can also not kite as well because you can't sprint, right? I'm not sure if this is worth a slot, right? You can just use immobility potions, you can escapist poisons and stuff, right? Obviously, this is 100% uptime. But, I mean, maybe on something... Yeah, I'm wondering what's cleansable, to be honest, no idea. Maybe the Templar ability, which... I'm not sure. Yeah, I was thinking about Stem Sorc or something, right? You have streaks, so you can still LOS easily. Yeah, you can hit the street, right? You have your Hurricane, you have your Streak and stuff, right? The question is this worth an item slot, right? Basically, you lose a monster set for this. I mean, it could have some potential, right? Especially in perma-block builds, right? I mean, you perma-block and you can't even be snared or rooted for a second something, right? You just hold your block the whole time and nothing happens, basically. If you combine this with the other set... could be strong, but more for... I don't know. Maybe for 1vx, but I'm not sure if it's an item slot worth, right? Ring of the Wild Hunt... Oh no, wait, I forgot those are specific... Yeah, medium feet, okay. Ring, increase your movement speed while in combat... Okay, this is OP as fuck, what the heck. I mean, there are already kiting builds, right? There are some people which are already running like fucking Sonic Fruit Cyrodiil, right? And your traitor? No, but you can't. Increase your movement speed while out of combat. Oh, increases! Ah! Oh, I read this as decreases. I thought this was the downside. Outside of combat, you're slowed. Okay, well then this is, yeah, of course, if you use it with Fjord's Legacy and let's say Marauder's Haste or something. And the downsides in ESO, yeah. Okay, well then, yeah, this is best in slot for every resource gatherer and stuff, right? And even in combat, 15% in combat, this is a lot. For 1vx, if you make your Sonic build and you kite around and LOS and stuff, this is huge. Again, it's overall interesting to see how those One Piece effects will flow into builds, right? I mean, you gotta keep in mind, you sacrifice a slot for a different set. Yeah. Brutality Ring. Increases your damage then. Interesting. That's quite interesting. Gotta see how the numbers pan out for this, to be honest. Okay, I can't say if this set is good. It seems... How do dots work again? Do dots crit or... I'm not sure. Did dots crit or not? Yeah. Because if dots not critting, then you get basically 25 damage increase for dots. You have spoilers, okay? Shoot ahead. Impen. I mean, I know about impen chains, but we get into this, right? Oh, okay, the number, yeah. I know that it's getting lowered, but not the number. Okay, this could be strong. I have to look into dots, right? But it could be really... dot builds could use this item, right? 25% damage. Imagine this on a necromancer dot build. Yeah, I know about this change. I just didn't see the numbers yet, right? But I think we will get to it, right? Okay, Torch of Necklace. While stamina is less than... Yeah, I mean, what? How does this work together with High Elf, for example? I mean, it seems okay, right? But I mean, getting recovery, it's quite a lot, right? To be fair. Oh, wait a second. This can be, yeah, this can be triggered at the same time, right? It's not an exclusive thing. While you have the extra magicka recovery, you can't have the stamina recovery. I mean, if you craft with both flow, you get recovery for both, basically, right? Could be interesting. Oh, my music ran out. Let me make the music again. I played this album already a couple of times, but I like it so much. I can see some use here, definitely. 400 is quite a lot. But does Vampire still have the extra recovery? Gonna check out the Vampire chains, but I think they said something about removing the recovery from Vampire, right? So it only scales with your champion points, basically. Okay, new collectibles. Okay, blah blah blah, heads, skins, oh, skins. Okay. So you probably, you have only to do the web trial, nothing else, okay. New homes, okay. Okay, new homes. It's a question, they didn't add any in-game homes for quite a while, which you can buy in-game, right? So it's a question, are those Groundsler items again, or can you actually buy them in-game? Because it's really about time to make new homes which you can buy in-game. Okay, new furnishings, yeah, new motifs, yeah. Crafting ingredients. Really? Really? This is a joke, right? This is a joke, right? Okay. Imagine you 1v1. Imagine you fight a Zerg and one of those guys has a poison with this effect. The pseudo player gets screwed, right? Okay, not a big fan, not a big fan at all. No, no. I mean, I have to see the numbers, how strong it is, right? But... okay, I see a problem here. For 1vx, I see a problem. I mean, already your healing is going to be reduced. You get this effect and you can't charge as much ultimate. So, can you please stop making content for circles, circlings, really? I mean, everyone can enjoy his playstyle, but at least solo players, give them a chance, holy. Oh boy. Okay, enchanting. Indigo. Okay, that's nice, I guess, right? So you get prismatic recovery, probably means you get tri-stat, you get stem recovery, magicka recovery, and health recovery. And reduce skill cost, then probably you get stamina, magicka, and health skill cost reduction. Depends on the numbers how strong this is, right? Yeah, but this is makes sense, right? And they are pushing their hybrid builds again. Okay, vampire updates. Vampires have received significant change this update. Can I teach you? Oh, new vampire quest, okay. Oh no, please no. Why do they do this? I mean, it was already annoying with the necromancer. I get it, some player wanna experience the world and they wanna be, the lore should fit. But this is just annoying, so you can't cast any abilities in towns. And some people, I know it sounds stupid, but some people are just used to refreshing their buffs and stuff, right? Okay, our vampires are set to stage 1. Okay, so they reversed basically the vampire stage. So what used to be the 4 is now the 1, what used to be the 1 is now the 4. I mean, with the reverse, obviously how feeding works, not the order and power, right? Okay, each vampire stage grants, yeah, that's like before, right? Health recovery gets reduced as high on your vampire stage, okay. Yeah, okay, blah blah blah, now. Unique cutscene animations, so... so this is basically now like the Blade of Woe, right? They play this little cinematic thingy with some camera angles and stuff. Which is probably because people know the executes from Skyrim, right? Yeah, similar to Blade of War, there it goes, yeah. Yeah, this is... don't like the Criminal Act thing. Oh, for real, they even took it further. You can't interact with NPCs in Vampire of Stage 4, really. With merchants. Okay, this could be annoying, I guess. You may be able to convince them otherwise. Okay, that's probably like a dialogue option, right? From your Vampire passives, like we have with the Mage Guild and with the Fighters Guild. So you can just talk them into... maybe mind control them or something, okay. Oh, they added... what? They added more spots to get rid of vampirism, okay. Because so far it's not known, right? People know it from the ground store, but there is already one quest in the game where you can get rid of vampirism, which is completely free, basically. Okay, there we go. Train Essence. This ability has been removed and eviscerate, okay? Okay, they replaced the skin, skill. Mist Film. This ability has been moved to the 5th skill. So they just changed order, right? Okay. Ability Training Magicka. Okay, so it trains your mana while it's active. And you can't use abilities, okay. This morph remains unchanged, grants you makes a... Okay. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay, gonna see the numbers for this one, definitely, right? I mean, it could be fine, right? I don't think... it's not the ultimate, right? So it doesn't deal as much damage, but... If you remember the old meta when you used Bat Swarm, right? Bat Swarm was OP as heck. Basically, you're casting Bat Swarm on cooldown, you bursted everything around you, and everything melted, right? I don't expect this as to be as strong, but it's definitely a back throw. It's kind of similar, right? Of course, you can't use any other skills, but I think if you just use the skill, this shouldn't be strong enough to survive much, right? It's just an escape. Okay, Bat Swarm. This ability has been removed. Okay. Blood Sign is probably the transformation, right? Okay, Eviscerate. My lock. Wait, Chroma Lock, is my chat still working? this new skill is a direct damage melee attack. Deals more damage based on your own missing hair. Yeah, it is. Okay, was just wondering. The new skill set is a direct damage melee attack that deals more damage based on your own missing health. Oh. Okay. Okay, will be. Will always be a critical strike if you use it while under half health, okay? Okay, I have to see the numbers on the skill, right? I mean, it seems. Can you make a cheese build around this? I mean, you could kind of cheese it, right, with, how is it called? The Mage Guild ability, balance, or... I'm not sure, there is one where you can sacrifice health, right? Sacrifice health to get resources. And when you use this one on a Nightblade, you could artificially, with this skill, decrease your health. And then this damage scales with how much health you have, so you can basically sneak around, reduce your health and control how much health you have, and then maximize basically the bonus damage. And maybe for gank builds this could be interesting, right? But have to see the numbers, but I can see a gank build around this, right? Okay. Toggle offer outside of global cooldown. Oh, and also zero welcome. While it's toggled on, you gain massive bonus to weapon. Wait, what? While it's toggled on, you gain... Oh, okay, so it's a synergy, okay. Cannot be healed by other players, yeah. Okay, so you activate the skill, you get trained, you go invisible, and then you gank with this skill, basically, right? Okay, this... well, I'm not sure if it's OP, but I have to see the numbers, right? But it sounds interesting, at least. I mean, a new gank style would be kind of cool, right? Increases the weapon spell damage bonus. Okay, so it becomes basically stronger at the cost of more health, okay? This one... is a question. Do you get, like, a burst heal? Get you all the health... back at once, or is it then like a heal over time, basically? Oh, okay. Yeah. I mean, this sounds kinda interesting. I wouldn't be opposed to having you gameplay style, right? I mean, it comes with a risk, right? If you can't get out there, you're already at a low health pool, right? I mean, gotta see how much this is. Maybe you can just activate this right after the tank and you're fine health-wise. But otherwise, it's a higher risk, higher reward. I kinda like this, to be honest. This combination here. But we have really to see the numbers here. Okay, Vampiric Train. New skills, short channel beam ability. Okay. Restores a portion of your missing... Wait, but why only stamina? Why not... Generates ultimate over the channel. Okay. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. This new skill is short channel beam ability, so it looks like Soul Assault or the Jesus Beam from Templar, right? But it doesn't deal much damage, but it heals you for amount of your missing health. Okay, this is the question. Heals you for a significant amount of missing health. Does this mean it scales with your missing health, or... It seems like it's scaling with your missing health, right? Yeah. Restores a portion, but stamina, okay. That's kind of BA, it's kind of strange. I mean, they kind of push nowadays all this hybrid stuff, so it's kind of strange to see only stamina and not magicka. But generates ultimate, you heal and degenerate ultimate. So I guess, have fun in Alikir Desert, right? Yeah, when you have to do this in Alikir Desert, they are running this for sure, I guarantee you. I mean, obviously we have to see the number, how strong is the heal and stuff. But in duels, this could be great cheese, great cheese. Not a big fan of this description, this could be overpowered. Obviously the numbers here could suck, then it's not really useful, but... not a big fan, not a big fan. New skill is crowdable, this affects all enemies in the cone in front of you, stunning them if they are facing your direction, okay? So you can't stun them from behind, they have to come towards you and then you stun them. Affects all enemies around you. So this is basically a get the hell out of there skill, right? Basically, if you get 1vx, you will get zerked. This is the skill you use to try to get out of there, right? So they are all grouping up on you, you use this stun. Oh, Enchained, hello. Why would anyone run Vampire and Cremor? I'm currently checking out the change, so we're going right through the Vampire change, and I'm trying to think if it is any good, right? So, gonna read everything up there. But yeah, this seems like the get the hell out there ability. I mean, it's not bad, but... could be useful, let's say that, yeah. Blood Scion. Okay, this new ultimate is a transformation, yeah. Instantly heals you into full health. Not a big fan. While transformed, you increased health, stamina, magicka. You can see enemies through walls. Okay, so it's like tap targeting, right? Like when you tap target someone, but it's permanently on every opponent. Okay. While transformed, you have increased health, so you are like a mini emperor, basically. And you heal for your damage. Okay, this sounds from the description OP as heck, really. What the heck? Obviously, I don't have the numbers here, so I can't... But you have basically a free temporal guard, right? You press ultimate. Now, I'm not sure if it has like a transformation animation and if you need to wait for the whole animation before you get your health pool, right? But if it's like an instant transformation, it's basically the oh shit button I need to recover, right? So like temporary guard, basically. Instantly full health, okay. Then you have increased health, stamina and magicka. And you heal for damage course. Yeah, like Necro Ultimate. But Necro Ultimate only heals you for some health, right? It doesn't fully heal you, or? Don't think so, right? Like 15k stats you get, what? Okay. This is like Bash Necromancer at release, right? Completely overpowered. I don't need to see the numbers. I know ZeniMax, they will make this overtuned as heck, yeah. And then they nerf it into the ground until it's not usable anymore. Okay, bat swarm around you while transform. Oh, so it is like the old bat swarm meta, right? You remember the old permablock bat swarm meta, right? Where you just had one bat swarm after another and you killed everything while you couldn't be killed. Okay. You're sent to Vampire Stage 5. Okay. With none of the drawbacks. So basically you don't have a punishment on health recovery, right? Okay, but depending on the healing here, on the healing per damage, this may be the better morph, right? And skill costs. Oh yeah, also the skill costs and fire weakness. Oh, okay. So you become a huge juggernaut, basically, right? So this is probably better in smaller skirmishes, and this is better... I guess this is better when you 1v1x, right? When you maybe like small scale and you bait the big Zergs out, right? So you survive longer because you deal more AoE damage and you get more heal. Skill cost, okay. I have to see the numbers for this, okay? So, but I would say, in general, this is probably for smaller fights and this is probably for the big fights. But I mean, even this is also useful in big fights, right? So, okay, but this ability, it sounds OP. It sounds OP, let's be honest, right? 20% increased cost and you don't get the drawback anymore, okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay, not a big fan. I think this is kinda OP, right? So, have to see this in action. Gonna wait for some PDS videos. Okay, Savage Feeding, blah blah blah, Supernatural Recovery. Yeah. Okay, so they removed all the old passives. Undeath, just moved to the 5th passive skill in skill line. Damage taken by up to... Okay, so they just make a smoother transition between the stages of recovery, right? So it's now based... yeah, okay. Okay. Remove. So now we ignore movement speed penalty. So this is like the old one, but you don't have this weird thing that it's only overnight, okay. So I can still use this on my bomber, basically, right? Okay. Okay, so I still use this on my bomber, nice. New skill line. Okay, Fiat, blah blah blah, Strike Shadow. Holy shit! It grants... grants a short bonus to your weapon and spell damage after leaving sneak. Oh, I definitely stay vampire on my bomb plate. Definitely, holy... bomb plate buff, this is nice, this is really great, holy shit. And obviously it's also worth considering for night plates probably to run vampire, right? Just for this passive. Okay, so gank builds are getting a huge buff here. I can live with that, actually. I mean, gank builds can be annoying, right? But I take it. I take it, definitely. Unnatural movement, new skill. Ghost skill. Wait a second. Wait a second. It reduces the cost of sprint. Okay, stamina buff confirmed, I guess. Okay. So basically, let's say you are a Stumsorg. Stumsorgs already have high movement, right? On a Stumsorg, he has sprint reduction. I mean, some Stumsorgs already run something like Steed or something just to be mobile. So if you LRS around the corner while sprinting, you go invisible. Holy fuck, okay. This is strong. This is really strong. Especially if you combine it with, let's say, immovability potion or something, right? So you can't get stuck. We have multi-core support in 2020, wow. Heads up, heads up. Thought we need to wait another 5 years. I mean, didn't they already in Somerset introduce multi-core support? I mean, they promised it and then it never worked, right? So, yeah. Okay, I mean, that's nice, right? Improving performance. Optimized how characters are drawn in the client. Okay, so you don't get people on lower spec PCs or with an HD instead of an SMD. They experience like silhouettes by loading in, right? And this is now reduced probably. Okay. Further improvement performance, lots of effects, particles. Okay, yeah, this is nothing. It's a general statement, right? They don't promise how good this improvement is, how it works, it's just... Yeah, we have less stress from particles. That's basically all they say, right? But they don't specify anything. Okay. Made numerous small optimizations to reduce memory. That's nice. It's pretty heavy on the memory usage. Okay, that's nice. That's especially with people with lower specs probably a main difference. Yeah, this is nice. It's pretty heavy on the memory side, right? Oh, Imperial City updates. Okay, that's interesting. Okay, new dailies. Okay. Okay, during events we get more world bosses, okay. Probably because people complained that they couldn't complete the achievement for the event Meteor Mayhem. Okay. I mean, I can live with this kinda, right? It's a good change, I think. But you still need to hunt them down, kill them before enemy players do. Then kill those animals. Yeah. PvP jokes and patch notes. Feels weird, man. All daily quests are now unallocated from meeting. Okay, this was one thing. You needed to complete the main story in Imperial City before you get the daily quests. Okay. Yeah, this is how the new dailies look like, not going over that. I mean, I usually do one daily a day just for the thing where you can later on buy the helmet and the costume, right? Because those sell for quite some good money. Housing precision mode. Okay. Oh, that's nice. That's... Yeah, sorry, I'm a housing fan too. I'm one of the housing plebs. Okay. To use this new mode, simply point out previously placed. Oh, nice. Oh, finally. Holy shit. That was one of the most annoying parts about the housing it did, alright. You always had sometimes, depending from which direction you interact with a object, it somehow auto-corrected your camera and sometimes to the most impossible position to anything, to see anything, and now they basically have a free editing mode. That's a great change. Okay, hell yeah. Toggle between movement and rotation. Okay, positive change, I like this. I like this really. That's great. Okay, this is great. I mean, I'm sorry that I'm more excited about this than the PvP chains, but yeah, it's just such a pain. If anyone saw my arena, right, it's a play. I placed anything without any add-ons and it was a pain, really. Okay, new furnishings, blah, 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 new achievements. Yeah, new motors, yeah. Okay, this is just something about general. Okay, what do we go? No issues. Yeah, blah blah. Okay. Okay, that's nice. We are currently doing Asylum plus 2 progression with my guild, so that's quite nice. Sorry. Okay, that's a blah blah. Okay, this is fixes and improvements. Tap abilities are now once again the global cooldown. Okay. So you can't spam them, or what does this mean, right? Tap abilities such as restoring. Those are basically the ones which you target at corpses, right? Global cooldown. Okay, gonna see. I mean, it's been a while since I played my mech necromancer, but it felt clunky as heck, so... Maybe this makes it better? Okay, didn't know this was a thing. Yeah, this ranking up stuff, yeah, it's just relevant for leveling. Fix an issue where casting disability... Okay. Yeah, that's nice, I guess. I mean, Necromancer is still a mess, right? Yeah. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. What? Okay, so basically this is from the spider stage, right? Where you have to throw those things on the spider webs to make them disappear. So now you have priority for the stitches. Okay. So it's a more potential for flawless runs to be ruined by accidentally main score runs by accidentally using one of the stitches instead of this, but other than that, it's a good change, I guess. Yeah. Cloudrest. Nice. Okay, do they also have some class changes? Oh, and there we go. Okay, combat and gameplay. Oh boy, what did they do? What did they do this time? Synergies now have a hierarchy to determine which synergy appears first when... Okay. No! No! This is so annoying. Okay, this is annoying. You know why? If you've ever been in Cloudrest, the gate spawns next to you. You want to use in synergy, bam, you're soaked into the gate, right? This is what happens now. Basically, the gate synergy appears over the in-game synergies, like your orbs or whatever you need, right? Okay, this... Not a big fan. Okay. Healing and shield is first. Utility buff, debuff second. Okay. Yeah, I mean, maybe some small scale groups have to get used to this. You know, I mean, we still have the harmony bombs, bomb groups, right? So I guess they have to adapt a little bit and don't spam heal synergies over the damage synergies, I guess. But it's just a minor change. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So heals, buffs, debuffs, and damage. Oh, interesting. Oh, that seems like a buff, right? Okay, it's kinda a buff. Update and optimize the logic menu test. Okay, I'm gonna see if this actually works. So this is more interesting for Cyrodiil, right? So if all the calculations are made simplified, right, then it should be a smoother experience in Cyrodiil, basically. Okay. Okay. Fix numerous issues. Okay, so gap closes are more reliable while you're immobilized, like snared or something. You can still, let's say, how is it called from the two-handed? You can your two-handed jumps and stuff like this, or dragon leap. Okay. Okay, wait a minute. Pet basic attacks can no longer remove players from stealth. Okay, this makes sense. Only special area of effect attacks that require special activation. Such as Blast Bones ultimates removes the... Okay, what do they mean with special area of effect attacks? So let's say, for example, I am on my Magicka Dragon Knight and I use my Flame Breath. Does this count as a special AoE? I guess so, right? Oh. Oh, and... Oh, no. Does this include Streak, is the question. Does this work with Streak? Is Streak considered a special area of effect? Yeah, I know that they made this primarily for the pets, right? But I'm just worried when they formulate it like this, right? I'm kind of worried if they make a decision. Some abilities are okay, and some abilities may not be okay, right? So the question is Streak a special activated ability, right? Okay, I have to see. Maybe it's just a strange wording, right, for this change. Maybe it's really just about the pets, so your AoE from Volatile Familiar doesn't reveal, or let's say more of the Infernal Fire Breath doesn't reveal players, right? It's probably that, I guess. Okay. Oh, so you don't actually... Wait a second. What does this mean? Pet summoning abilities now have a preventive window after completing their cast that prevents attempting to summon them again while they're already... So does this mean I just can't reactivate them as soon as I summoned it? I mean, there's already... If your summoning gets cancelled, there's already downtime, right? But does it block the skill at all? Means if I'm in a clutch situation, my Matriarch just died, I summon my Matriarch and obviously I wanna instantly cast my Matriarch heal. Is there now a time window where I can't use my heal after resummoning the pet? Okay, this is interesting. Pet summon, attempting to summon them again. Or was that just a bug when you spammed it too fast that you did like auto-cancel the animation or something? But yeah, if this means I can't use the active ability as soon as it's up, this would be a huge nerf, to be honest. But gotta see how it works. Probably inherit parents bonus related to armor, such as... Okay, that's nice. Oh, that's nice. Sometimes if you're under pressure, you wanna get the LOS, but you also wanna get your pet out. Yeah, and I noticed that it sometimes gets cancelled for no reason. Okay. Okay, that's weird. Okay. Yeah, that's pointless. Yeah, okay, that's okay. Oh boy, reduce the damage of bashing by 80%. Wait, 80% damage reduction on bashing. What the heck? So I guess there's no chance of seeing... Okay, so this is more of a stamina buff. I mean, in stem classes you do some bash animation cancels or something, right? Well, oh, sounds a little bit over the top. 80% bash reduction. Okay. I mean, I'm kinda okay with it, but it seems a little bit overtuned, right? Here we go. Increase the healing reduction of Battle Spirit to 60, up from 50%. Here we go. Not a big fan. I'm saying it as it is. Yes, we have a tanky meta. Yes, we have insane heals in the game. But together with the poison, which I mentioned earlier, right? We saw this new poison, which reduces ultimate generation for solo players, right? when you have a Zerg is running around spamming AoE heals, spamming regen, spamming all the buffs across the board, they won't notice a 10% difference. However, a solo player will notice this way, way harder. And of course, I have my Magicka BAs, right? Magicka often revolves around burst tiers. A stamina character who has his vigor ticks going on won't notice much of a difference, right? The vigor is up high as fuck anyway, right? So vigor isn't a problem, but for burst tiers, Magicka classes, oh boy, 20% difference. Ah, so yeah. Yeah. Okay, one thing, I think this hits Magicka harder than it hits stamina harder. And second, I think against in small scale and solo players, this screws them. I mean, everyone I know, Bislubo and all the others are saying this is a nice change finally, not everything is so tanky. This hurts the player base, the solo players. And ball groups are getting stronger basically because they won't notice this huge difference. So you will have your ball group guilds coming back to Cyrodiil. Yeah, as you say, most mech classes basically, right? Yeah. And also it makes healing stuff even more useless, right? I mean, these days mech decay, mech blur, they all can run sword and board. Mates with pet run sword and board anyway. And even you see petless sorks with sword and board, right? So it's even less of a reason to run. Why would I run resto stuff for the regen and my light champion or whatever the ultimate is called if I could just go sword and board with temporal gourd, right? Yeah, all the stem classes, they have high vigor tooltips and other healing sources as well, but they won't notice the difference. But mech classes are getting shafted here, really. Yeah. So I can say it, I'm not a big fan. I mean, stamina classes are already overperforming, by the way. I mean, yeah, I'm a mech Zork pleb. I know mech Zork is tier 1 at the moment. It's up there, right? But on the mech side, you have mech Zork, stamina, necromancer, warden, decay, right? And this is only increasing this gap between stamina and Magicka. And it also makes it harder for solo players and small scale players compared to the huge Zergs. Not a fan, not a fan. I know I'm fully BA's. I'm a mech Zork main since years, right? So obviously, yeah, I know mech Zork has its issues, right? It's pretty strong in terms of mobility and stuff, right? Survivability. But still, not a fan, not a fan at all, really. I mean, I like that they try to change to switch around the meta a little bit, but no, not like this, really. Okay, buffs and debuffs, updated multiple abilities and item sets. This fix can help. Okay, so they don't want to have as much stacking, okay. 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 I'm not really familiar with Nightblade or Soul Shreds. Okay. Yeah, it's kind of mess. Wait, fixed an issue where this ability stun could ignore line of sight or range. So sometimes you could cast it even if the target is out of range. Or, and does this mean if I now get the rune cast, rune cage on me and I walk into LOS, it just get cancelled? Or, I mean, I didn't use this ability in ages, so no idea. Okay, fixing those visuals. Okay, but they didn't nerf it, right? So they didn't make, this is more like fixes instead of actually adjustments to values and stuff, right? Because Overlord at the moment is overperforming quite a lot, right? And they also didn't fix the bug where you can still use it after activating an ultimate, right? Yeah, only fixes, no change. Okay, got it. But they didn't fix it, right? Because Overlord, the way it currently works, you can cast, let's say, you go into Overlord, then you cast the Meteor or Ice Comet, and then you can still fire one Overlord light attack even though you don't have any ultimate anymore. That's how it currently works, right? And they didn't fix this one. So if you are playing a Soak Bomber, you can still use this combo, basically, right? Okay, Templars and Fire, Reflective Light, fix an issue. Yeah, nobody cares. Fix an issue, but it could not block. Oh, okay, so the... yeah, so it can be cancelled, okay. Ferric, fix an issue where this could not be interrupted. Oh, so now you can basically... I don't know in any situation where this happens, but when someone is summoning his squad, you can bash him like you can cancel the Matriarch. Okay. Oh, okay. Nice. Oh, so this is a buff to Warden, okay? Kinda, right? If there wasn't... I mean, direct damage can trigger some different effects, right? So... yeah, exactly what it needed. Okay, restoration stuff. Heavy attack. Update the heavy attack with this weapon. To operate more closely to the lightning stairs that we now have two minor ticks. Yeah, but I mean, with the Battle Spirit chains, nobody plays restoration stuff anyway, right, in PvP, so... yeah, nobody cares. Okay, Vampire, Mistform, fixed numerous issues. Yeah, with the healing chains and with the impen chains, I wouldn't be surprised if we are back to the permaplug meta, really. Okay, Mistform, blah blah. Oh, now we go. Okay. Werewolf experience. Okay. While at full health, restores stamina. Okay. Okay. Read please this. Received minor updates. Gain major brutality. Minor updates. Major. Holy shit. Okay, okay. Ah, major berserk. Okay, man. Sure. Why not? Why not? Yeah. Major berserk. Okay, but at least you take more damage. But still, Major Berserk, what the heck? This ability now also increases your stamina recovery. Yeah, but people run this morph, right? Major Berserk for free, hello? Okay. 10% more damage, okay. But just to... so if someone is running from you, you can't use it to finish them, right? It's just effective if someone is on you, okay. Hound of Agony, decrease the damage bonus. Okay, okay. With an aggressive execute scaling bonus, what the heck? Okay, so Werewolf has an execute, right? It's now... yeah. Wait, Carnage now already? Okay, you have a sustain morph or a bongos damage morph, okay. Disability now also become off balance for 7 seconds by slot disability in its morph. Major savagery, okay. This more for now. Oh, heavy attack speed. Okay, that's something new. Did they ever mess around with heavy attack speed? Damage, okay. But wait a second, wait a second. Wait a second. Does anyone see this? Increases your physical and spell penetration by 13.3k against off-balance enemies. This ability now also causes enemies to become off-balance for 7 seconds. Oh boy, werewolf. I think we found a new meme, right? Minor updates to its toolkit. Okay, so with this new set, he gets over 13k penetration and he can reliably proc off balance. Okay, werewolf. Yeah, screw vampire, really. Nobody plays vampire, people will go werewolf. What the fuck? What the fuck? Okay. Okay, this is bonkers. Werewolf just got... Holy shit. Okay. Werewolf will be meta. Okay, now I know what Romalok meant earlier, really. Now I know what you were saying there. Holy shit. Okay, I mean, werewolves were in a kind of bad spot at the moment, right? But still. Silver ball, fix an issue, I just. Yeah, nobody cares, man. Nobody uses, undo, fix. Okay. I mean, this ability now is at least fixed, right? Undo. This was a really pleasant surprise, it made my gameplay way better. And I can finally use the active effect. Fix an issue. Okay, lines of support, barrier increase. wait, do I see this right? They nerf Zergs. Is this really a Zerg nerf or am I dreaming at the moment? I mean, it's not huge, right? But 50 more ultimate. And they fixed the bug that it can be applied to non-group targets. Wow! Okay. I mean, as a solo player, I take what I can get, right? So, this, I'm okay with this. I'm really okay with this. Yeah. Gonna see, for PvE is a question. Not sure if it's really a huge difference to have 50 more ultimate, right? Some people use it in PvE, but PvP, not a bad change. I like this. This is at least something good to take away, right? Shadow Strike. Okay. Oh, it didn't work. Okay. Oh, unarmed. Yeah. Consumables. Updated Alliance Force score. So. Wait. Ah, now the Alliance stuff is as powerful. Okay. Get it. Oh, now we come to the fun here. This set is perfect version of Grand Empower. Okay. Yeah, Ember Blossom buff. Yes. I'm already running this set. I still have the old school Shacklebreaker Ember Blossom setup sometimes. And I will probably get rid of my Vampire on my Sorc, so that's nice. So I will have a higher recovery, yeah. Okay, this is great. This is such an underrated set. Ember Blossom is just really one of the best mech sets out there. Okay. Okay. So this is a buff to Archmage. Yeah, I was memeing about this set basically when they were discussing the light and heavy attack change, which they now scrapped, right? But when it was in the talks, I was actually memeing that we may use this set then with heavy attacks to have our sustain, right? Okay, Ashen Crypt, the set now deals damage. Okay, that's close. Fixed issues, okay. Wow, oh holy. Okay, and this is a huge number, right? 8k more. But I don't have the set in my mind right now. This set no longer works with channeled effects or beams. Okay, so it doesn't work with Zahn anymore, right? But it still works with Grofdor, Elampress and stuff, right? Okay, this is a nice change. It was kind of OP, right? Especially if you had something like a Mech Decay with Zahn and Asylum, Inferno stuff and other bullshit, right? Ember Shield. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, most of these sets don't tell me anything. Didn't look into them in ages. Chris and Pluto. Okay. That's nice. Oh, okay, this was a question, right? If they change the impen, will this set become a meta, right? But, okay, it seems like they adjusted it, okay. So nobody will be forced to run this set. Okay, this set now increases the ramp damage. So it makes it more as a reliable execute set, right? Okay. Leeching Blade, fixed issues. Okay. So 6.4k armor, okay. Oh, this could be a nice defensive set, right? Wow, okay, this is good, right? So Queen's Allegiance now is more attractive for PvP, right? Because I have built-in sustain. Now I don't know the damage number. Did it go up? Did it go down? Because it's kind of strange when it's worded. It was 20% damage before, and now it's exactly 2600, so I can't evaluate, right? What? So this was basically used to be better on sets which really directly spec'd into light attacks, and this is more of a flat option, right? So it also works with builds which don't scale too high with your light and heavy attacks. But yeah, for overload the stuff could still be useful, right? Okay. I mean, I like this change, kinda, I guess. I have to see the numbers. I like this change, it was kinda OP. I like Ember Blossom change, that's really great. Straight up buff to Ember Plasm, I love it, really. Okay, what else do we have? Rope. Is this set now reduced damage taken? Okay. Doesn't look too good, right? Ropes of the Hills, slightly redesigned. Ah. Okay, I see where they're going here. Yeah. Yeah, okay. So, this is kinda to prevent the permablock meta, right? Set a heal over time. The way it worked, right? You got healed while you were in the snare, right? And in snares you can still block, right? But now you need to get out of the disabling effect until you get your bonus, right? So you can't just stay in the disabling effect and hold block, basically. So they kinda countered the initiative to go into a block meta, right? I mean, it's not a huge change, but... Right? Because snares are disabling, but you can still hold block. And now you need to get out there before you can block again, otherwise you don't get your heal, so you can't just stand still. Okay, that's a nice change, I guess. Ropes and... Wait, and Ropes of Transmutation got buffed though, right? But it's... Oh, it's shortened as heck, okay. So it's kinda nerfed, right? What? Okay, didn't know that. Face an issue, what is it? Increase the damage bonus. Okay. They are really pushing the heavy attacks, right? Okay, blah blah blah, one pilot. What? Okay, well, this is bullshit, right? So if you want to be a full-on vampire role player, then you use the set probably, and then you just use vampire abilities, okay? Oh, here we go. Oh, no, not Balorg. Wow. Wow, is this a buff actually for Bombos? I mean, the way actually currently Bombos use, you could have obviously bombed with New Moon Acolyte and with Spinners, right? But usually the meta is Vicious Death, Balorg and Mechanical Equity, right? Because crit damage is just stronger than going the penetration route. And now, yes, you sacrifice some of your damage, but you get extra pen, which you didn't have access to earlier with the Mechanical Equity build. So to my Bomber build, this is actually a huge buff, really. That's a nice buff to the... I can't say if it's huge, but I think it's a buff, definitely. At least for the Mechanical Equity setup for Bombos, right? Outside of that, hard to say. I mean, it's solid, right? It's just switching around how the damage works, basically. The only thing is, obviously, if you use this set before on normal builds, like, don't know, with Onslaught or something, obviously you don't get as much weapon damage or spell damage, which means you get less heals, right? But you, through the pen, you probably get more damage, but you can't buff your own heals and stuff, right? So that's a downside, I guess. So, but for bomb plates, this is a buff, definitely. Bloodspawn. Oh no, reduce the armor granted from this set. Okay, so the set is basically dead, right? RIP Bloodspawn. I mean, Bloodspawn, to be fair, it's the most powerful monster set in the game for PvP, right? Everyone and his mother is running this set, right? So it needed a change, but this is the Zenimax hammer again, right? They basically said, okay, make it usable or make it trash. Halving, almost halving the armor. Reducing the ultimate gain. This set is pretty much dead now. Okay, rip Bloodspawn. It was a great run. Great ride, Bloodspawn. You will be remembered. Okay, Choke Fawn. This set now heals for... Okay, strong here. Okay. So I guess, yeah, it's a stronger heal, right? But probably more relevance in PvE, I guess. Doomy House. Okay. Well, yeah, Doomy House is a nice change, right, for once. I mean, Doomy House will become popular anyway during the next patch, right? Not to the two-piece effect, but just for its one-piece effect, right? It's Stamina and Max Magicka, and anyone who is running one of the new one-piece legendaries is obviously thinking, what can I replace? And if you go the route, I replace a piece of my monster set, then Doomy House is probably one obvious choice as a one-piece, right? So gonna see how the builds plan out, but I think it will become more popular as a one piece, like it used to be back in the day in Morrowind, when two-handed only gave you a one piece effect basically. Then everyone, every Mechzorg back in the day was running Shackle Plagar, Lich, Master Inferno, and then one Doomy House, right? Okay, Earth Gore. This set now here's okay, so a buff, a nerf. Oh. It does less overall damage, and damage takes four seconds, okay. But reduce the cooldown, okay. So I'm not sure, this is... I mean, Earthcore is still used in PvP, and now it's probably dead. But in PvE, I think PvE players have to discuss this, how it influences them. I think for PvP, Earthcore was still annoying, but it was kind of in the right spot, right? I'm not sure. I think it was already enough to buff the nerfs in the past. Oh, Engine Guardian. This set now restores. Oh. Nobody gives a damn about the healing, right? Okay. Why do they nerf this set? What the heck? I mean, this is the ultimate kiting set, right? For let's say a Mechzorg, like in the open world, full on Malcolm playstyle, let's say it like this. This is the ultimate kiting tool, right? And I know it's strong, it's really strong, but the RNG is already annoying enough, right? You not always get it right, but halving the resources. I mean, you already had to justify running this set instead of Bloodspawn. I mean, now this isn't an issue anymore, rip Bloodspawn, but you already had to make the decision, do I replace a defensive set with Engine Guardian, right? Or maybe, I mean, even Shadowrend is kinda a defensive set, right? So, what are your options? You had Bloodspawn, Mighty Chudin, from Mechzorg perspective, you had Guardian and Sheen, Shadowrend, maybe Slimecraw if you really wanna go balls to the walls, right? But, yeah. This is hard, this is harsh, really. Not a big fan, not a big fan. Okay. 11% increase the damage from each ship meteor. Okay. Oh, nice. I mean, I already used the set in PvE, but getting Elampus buffed is even better, right? Okay, Infernal Guardian. Decrease the damage done from each mortal. Did this really need a nerf? Not sure. Ah, this set, I golded it out. It's a perfect meme set, right? But you never trigger this. I tried it in PvP. When it fires, it deals like 20k damage all at once, right? If you get it to trigger. It's 20k damage tooltip, but the proc condition, you need like 5 light attacks on the same target. In a time window, you can only get 1 stack per second. And then you only get the damage effect while the target is under CC, right? So if it isn't CC'd, it gets stunned. But if it's already stunned and has immunity, CC immunity, then it hits for 20k damage. It's a really nice set. It's a meme set, but I wouldn't use it. Don't recommend it. But if you just want a meme and you get it off, maybe in duels it's pretty strong, right? It's just you see people explode, 20k damage, they are vanished. But yeah, it's not practical at all for PvP, at least. Great, increase the damage per tick of the set to Kaya. Yeah. Oh, they are going really harsh on the armor bonus as well, not just impen, right? They basically reduce any armor set here. Oh, okay. Don't get a stack. Okay. Okay. Oh, higher proc chance, okay. Can no longer be targeted. Oh, that's nice. Dietroph cannot be targeted, so it doesn't get in the way. Okay, nice. And it also doesn't reveal stealth targets anymore, right? Because of the pet change. Change to one. Oh, but... Oh, okay, Mexica. So I guess this is a new option for... Could be an option for PvP now, right? For the Pet Sword Heroes. Damage data is always dear. Okay, it's a slight damage nerf, but more reliable basically, right? So it's definitely a new option for PvP. Okay, it's not hit as hard as I expected, okay. It's still 1.5k armor can make a big difference, but yeah. Increase the weapon with spell damage granted from the set. Okay. Increase the weapon with spell damage granted from the set. Yeah. Didn't they... weren't they about to make even huge change to the set, but I guess they cancelled the change with the... when they cancelled also the light attack change, right? I mean, now it's just a straight up buff, right? Not the rework which they planned. Okay, they're still pushing this DLC, okay. Increase the damage of the set. Increase the proc chance. No idea if this is good, but okay, one spell damage. Could be good, I guess. No idea. Ooh. I can tell you one thing, PvE Halos won't be happy, right? They already nerfed Earthgore, now they are nerfing Nightflame. But a higher proc chance, but does it really matter? I mean, it's not a huge difference, right? But I think healers in PvE are slowly running out of options, right? It used the one bonus of armor to... Again, a huge... So they basically all the One Piece effect, armor effects, they went down, went hard on them, okay. Increase the cooldown of the proc. So. Oh, I mean, Pirate Skeleton now is kinda in a good spot, right? It's not as dominant as it used to be in the past, right? So, yeah. So, they pack battle a little bit from the previous nerfs, basically. Probably to test the waters, right? Yeah. I can live with that. At the moment, it's not as OP as it used to be, basically. Scorch Harvester, decrease the damage of the set. Okay, that's a really minor change. But increase the chance. Yeah, just... moving around a little bit, the stats. Increase the damage of the set. Okay, Selena, more damage. So I guess this is for PvE most relevant, right? They wanna make it... I think Selena ran a little bit out of favor, right? I thought they're running other sets nowadays. Don't know, I don't play stamina classes in PvE. Increase the damage of the set. Okay, the set no longer... Okay, well... Okay. Increased, okay. Increased Magicka. So a slight buff to Sentinel, right? Okay, so it seems like they bring the healing sets a little bit more on one level, so there are more choices. Shadowrend. Okay, this effect cannot stack. Okay, nice. I was worried there for a second, to be honest. I mean, whenever they reduce a minor or major buff, you know it can stack, like with the armor potions at the moment. The armor potions aren't major resolve or minor resolve, so you can stack it on top of major resolve and minor resolve. And it's good that they removed this option here, that you can't apply MAME on top of this effect. Okay, that's nice. Even though it's still a little bit more, but yeah. To be fair, let's say a Mechzorg, Mechzorgs some used Shadowrend, right? And Mechzorgs don't really... do they have access to MAME? I don't think so, right? So it's a little buff for Mechzorgs, to be honest. Significantly reduces streamlined damage. But Okay, that's a huge nerf, okay. Okay, ah, that's a huge nerf, okay, never mind, never mind. I mean, I don't mind it if we see less Petzorgs, right? I mean, I'm a Petzorg, but I only use Matriarch, right? I don't go all the full route with Volatile Familiar and Shadowrend and stuff. Increase the damage. Okay, slight damage increase, Stonekeeper. Oh, wow. Okay, as I said, right? I said earlier with the change with his sub, they try to counter the permablock meta, and this is another one of those chains. Stonekeeper was a set when you hold block, and I think every 5 blocks you restore that much stamina and magicka and stuff, and they counter this by reducing this. Reduce the cooldown, okay. Okay. So they are actively countering the problem that people could use the impant chains to go into full sturdy into a permablock meta. Even though I think PvE players won't be happy with this change. Yeah. PvE players will hate this change, in fact, right? The tanks. Obviously, you can stack it faster now, right? This may balance it out, to be honest. Don't know. You can get four stacks now in the time you used to get one stack, basically. Okay. Wait, this means you get it in... It was like, it needed 5 stacks, right? So that's 1.25 seconds. It's 2. Wait. You get around the same value which you used to get for 2.5 seconds. But no, it had also a cooldown, right? It had a cooldown after the effect blocks, right? Okay, so you charge it faster, but you get half the resources. Okay, okay. Stormfist, increase the damage of final explosion, okay. Oh, this... Oh, Stormfist buff massively, holy shit. Could be good, I guess. I guess this would be strong if Stemstalk still had the implosion passive, right? Then this would be bonkers, right? Oh, and implosion is already ripped for some patches, so... Change the One Piece bonus of the set. Okay. Oh, so it's now a dummy house, basically, right? Okay. Oh boy. Okay. When I go right now to the forum into another thread, I can already predict there is a PvE healer thread about this change. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. Holy fuck, the... Wow. Okay, they completely... This got the Zenimix treatment. Definitely the Zenimix treatment. PvE players won't be happy about this. Okay, Torbokun reduce the damage per tick of the set. Oh, this was needed, this... Oh wait, increase the cooldown. Oh yeah, this set needed it. Oh, you saw it everywhere, right? This set was used everywhere nowadays, so it's nice. I don't... Maybe it's again a little bit too harsh, right? 100 to 400... from 400 to 100 and double the cooldown, but this set needed adjustment, definitely. Okay, that's a nice change. Maybe a little bit over the top, but I can see the reasoning. Increase the damage of the set, okay. Yeah, makes it more playable. It's Royal King, which we just have. Oof. Okay, okay, so it's only health recovery, okay. Whew, I expected a harsher change for Royal King, to be honest. I mean, so much as they went down the healing, right, would only make sense if they also got it this set, but yeah. Viking Soria, cool. We already heard about this change, spell pen instead of max health. Increase the splash metal. Yeah, I mean, it could be even stronger, right? Let me make some new music, by the way. Yeah, this could be actually stronger in some situations, and obviously it could be also weaker in some situations. Let me get my music. Dum, dum, dum. Yeah, let's play this one. Yeah, I mean, this could be stronger, right? But the problem is, when you had, let's say, a class like Mech Decay, you got away with using this set instead of, let's say, Bloodspawn or any defensive set, right? You could use this as an offensive set and you still got a little bit of health, so your defense was still kind of covered, right? Now you take a higher risk, but the spell penetration may be worth it, right? It's a damage boost overall, right? Yeah, so you don't have this kind of weird hybrid between defense and offense, but you get a full-blown offensive option, and it probably is even stronger in PvE too, right? Yeah. Valley Treff. Okay, increased damage. Okay, Zahn. Now it's getting interesting. Increase the initial damage of the set. Okay, increase the damage. Okay. Okay. So does this mean when you now keep it up longer, the longer you have this effect, the last tick may be higher damage, right? Or I mean, I don't do the math right now, it's way too complicated for me. But it means if you can stack the whole six seconds, the last stack, the last tick is more damage, right, than it currently is, or? Anyway, it's gonna be annoying as hell, right? 33%. Not sure about this. I mean, if you break it instantly, then it's not as bad as it's currently, but if you stay for the whole duration, it may be more annoying and it procs more often. Gonna have to see this in action, right? Zahn can be really annoying at the moment. Oh, and here we go. Asylum Sanctorum. How much have we left, by the way, and how late is it, by the way? It's... what time do we have, by the way? Oh, almost 3, okay. Okay, they didn't lie with the 50 pages, right? Asylum Sanctorum, Chaotic Whirlwind, Cosmic Whirlwind. Yeah. How do I have to understand this? The perfect version no longer has a unique, no longer has a unique value, instead grants you up to. So this means now the two-piece effect, the one-piece effect only applies to the perfected version, but the effect itself is the same as the base version, right? So let's say I have the imperfect asylum stuff. So far the difference was basically perfect asylum stuff, it's the effect hits every 2 times you cast it, and the imperfect version every 3 times. And now it's basically the imperfect version is also applying every 2 times, nor you get the one piece effect on top of it, right? Okay. Okay, I see it. So there is no difference in effect between imperfect and perfect version, it's just a bonus stat on the perfect version, okay. What the fuck? Enemies hit by arrow spray now have a... Oh, against incoming bow attacks, so if you wanna be Legolas, this is your set basically, right? Okay, Timeless Blessing, reduce the cost reduction. Yeah. Wait, but they only did this charge for the Asylum weapons? They only did this for the Asylum weapons, but they don't do this for the Black Rose weapons, what the heck? Wait, where? Ah, but wait, the Black Rose prison weapons didn't have a difference to begin with, right? Yeah, right. For example, my Black Rose resto stuff has the same effect currently as the perfect version, just it misses the stat. Okay, so basically they do to the Asylum weapons what it did to the Black Rose weapons, which was already there. Okay, I get it. Okay, but this means my imperfect Asylum stuff will finally be useful. That's actually quite great. Especially with Mech Decay at the moment. Okay, where are we? Choose the duration. Wait a second. Wasn't the Magicka recovery only like 129 or something? So it's only... Okay, this set got gutted, really. This is that, yeah. Reducing major vitality by 1 second, which already was, it's a short time window, right? Usually you need it on a bomber, I drop my ward into a regen or the other way around, whatever. Just get the health, you instantly get a huge health boost, right? But still, this makes it unusable, and this one, what's even the point in having the perfect version now, right? Not a fan. Yeah, Magicka classes really get cutted here. And another reason, I said it earlier, right? This patch won't have a reason to run resto stuff. This is another reason why you don't run resto stuff. So be happy, incoming sword and board meta, I tell you so much. Okay, this is trash. This set now increases your damage done, reduces your damage taken. Okay, we got another time, we got sussed. We got sussed again. Zenimax, please. This is bullshit. Holy. So this means classes with access to major protection can now stack their major protection on top of Plate Cloak. And they get extra damage. For real? Okay, this is a buff, this isn't a nerf. No, this is a buff. Isn't it Necromancer? Does Necromancer have major protection somehow? Or do I remember things wrong right now? Correct me if I'm wrong, but... Anyways, Necromancer has a bunch of reduction already that he can stack, right? And this is another extra stackable 10% damage reduction on a Necromancer. And a 10% damage increase. Holy fuck, they don't play their own game sometimes, really. Increase the damage the set does. Okay. Yeah, nice. Increase the damage done by the set. Yeah, I mean, nobody uses this anyway, right? Not sure if this is good in small scale, maybe, but... Yeah. Training story now. Okay, now it's getting interesting. Those are the new perfected versions, right? Okay, 103 weapon damage on the perfected version. Oh, okay, that's nice. A buff on the Master Bow, basically. Let me see. Did he, by the way, say if you will get something replaced here? Okay, they didn't make a statement if our old weapons are upgraded. I mean, you can check my YouTube channel. I made a meme run with doing mess from arena only with light attacks. People liked it quite a lot. Because it shows how stupid this decision is that your old versions don't get updated. Okay, which is the possible. So they don't say anything if you if they upgrade, okay. I think they will definitely change their mind on that. Choose the cost reduction of the set. Okay. Oh, I was here already, sorry. Destructive. Oh, this set now grants up to. Are we back in the game, boys? Yeah, I know this meme. That's why I made my yesterday I recorded a run where I did Maelstrom Arena only with light attacks and went on Reddit basically. And yeah, basically it showed the stupidity of this meme that they just created by not upgrading old weapons, right? So I hope they change their mind. But are we actually back with the Master Inferno? Are we back with the Master Inferno? That's the question. I mean, it seems good, right? 600 spell damage for 4 seconds. The cost reduction, obviously, the spell is expensive already. But it makes it, may make it usable again, right? So, I kinda like this. I mean, it's one step, right? At least it's not complete useless like it's at the moment, right? This set now grants up to Magicka Samir. Oh, this is a nice, for once the PvE healers will be happy there. And also, this makes it, I forget, when I get the perfected version, right, definitely worth to consider this weapon again. Has been a while. Increase healing penetration. Ooh, that's quite, what? Yeah. Okay, makes it stronger, right? But this is, considering all the previous nerfs to armor and healing, now they make such a huge change, seems kinda out of line, right? Doesn't really follow the logic here, I'm missing the red line there, to be honest. Is that now? Wait. Okay, this critical, okay. This set now increases your instance. But is this good or is this bad, to be honest? So it's more damage, but it's not bleed damage, so it doesn't synergize with, let's say, Deadly Strike, for example, right? Because Deadly Strike would also damage, buff this damage. But on the end, you get more direct damage or something. I guess it's a buff or something? Yeah, maybe a buff, I'm not sure. Increase the stamina. Okay. Yeah. Okay, now we got, yeah, this was the memo. Master Ice Backbar, yeah. Oh, Master Ice Backbar. Yeah, you can use it for the Master version is stunning, right? The frost stuff. And I mean, there is the One Piece set, right? You saw the One Piece set, the chest piece where basically you bash one target and he gets a debuff which can't be cleansed, and this debuff can't be cleansed and it doesn't end basically, right? So you get Magicka, as long as you block something you get Magicka, like 600 Magicka per block, right? And you can combine this with Ice Backbar, right? Throw in some Sturdy maybe and you have perma block. Yeah, and then if you need a stun, you get it. Yeah, or you can just do this, right? Yeah, but, I mean... Titanic Cleave. Okay. Yeah, but I'm referring to... Let me find the set, where is it? Where were the single sets? Ah, there we go. I mean this set here. this one here. Bloodlord's Embrace. Dealing damage with a Basher deck places a persistent, uncleansable Blood Curse on an enemy. Can only have one up, blah blah blah. Blocking an attack from a Blood Cursed enemy restores 685 Magicka. And this effect occurs every second. Ice stuff, yeah. In duels it's bonkers, right? In duels it's just straight up stupid, but even so. And right, frost stuff, you can have the passive, so you use Magicka for blocking instead of stamina, right? And now when you block, he gets Magicka back. And now throw in some sturdies, which further decreases the blocking curse cost, right? This is just stupid. That's a... yeah. I have no words for this set. And it can't be cleansed, nothing, right? Yeah, and with Ice Staff, you have the passive, you use Magicka for blocking instead of stamina. Holy shit. Okay. Okay, Maelstrom. Flurry increased the weapon's bad damage counters. Oh, that's quite a huge buff, holy shit. And weapon. Ooh. Very good. What? A buff to Crushing Wall? And Spell Penetrate. Holy. Now I see why they want people to reform this whole dungeon, yeah. Now I see why they want Maelstrom and people back here. Holy shit. Yeah, I got three of them, by the way, which won't be upgraded, apparently. Okay. No, I think I have four of them, not sure. Increase the damage done by this set. Okay, dice. And now it's a bleed, okay, okay. Ah, now it's a bleed. Yeah, I was wondering. This is the gap closer from two-handed, right? It was always weird that this effect isn't a bleed damage. It screws up a lot of calculations, right? And it gets a huge buff here, so... this is a good change. I was waiting for this, to be fair. Open some possibilities and some cheese bleed builds, probably. Decrease the magic upgrade from the set. Okay. Yeah, this is shit. Decrease the magic. Yeah. Okay, so the Legolas players. Yeah. Okay. Okay, added an extra measure to prevent Volantrung from being held longer than intended of being interacted with fire. Yeah, how about they fix also the Volantrung spawns? I mean, at the moment you have like, what, like 15 spawns or something, but 90% of times he always spawns in one of the locations closest to one alliance, right? It never spawns on the other spots, so they should look into this as well. And, wait, that's everything for Alliance Swarm? Okay. Fix an issue where your arrow would display correct. So, okay. Yeah, this is bullshit. Rotten economy. Blah. Blah blah blah. Yeah, I think that's it, right? Okay, this took way longer than expected. Oh, they are updating monsters. How about they finally update the NPCs in Zyrodiil? I mean, yeah. The mates are still stunning with crystal fragments, right? Yeah, that's it, basically. Oh, boy. Well, I guess it's time for some final thoughts, right? All in all, Vampire looks interesting. We have the downside with the ability cost, right? This may kill Vampire, I'm not sure. On the other hand, if it doesn't have such a harsh punishment, it seems pretty overpowered, especially the ulti, the gank combo, the passive with sprinting seems OP as heck, but obviously with the cost increase, yeah, it may balance things out, right? Werewolf completely broken, especially with the new set. The set gave 2x weapon damage, 1x penetration, and you get almost 14k penetration against off-balance targets, and Werewolf can trigger off-balance easily. And it gets another of our major buffs now. Werewolf will be bonkers, Werewolf will be played OP as hell. In terms of sets, yeah, kinda keep an eye against the set which I just mentioned with the penetration and damage, could be OP. The One Piece effect which I just showed you, right, with the uncleansable curse, you get Magicka for blocking. Combine this in combination with a Frost Staff for the Magicka block passive. Add some sturdy in there due to the Impen Chains perma block. Just not saying more, perma block. It's just annoying, okay. What else? One thing I didn't like is... Yeah. Next thing I didn't like, the healing change. The battle spirit change, no. I mean, first of all, we already have the BAs, as I said. We have Magicka and Stamina. Stamina is overperforming. You have your Necromancer, Warden, Stam Decay. On the magic side, you have Maxor. That's basically how the power balance is. The 10 or 20 or whatever it was healing difference, a Stem class with a Vigor with a high tooltip running already over seconds, he doesn't notice a 10% nerf, right? A Magicka class which relies on burst here notices this difference, right? And again, from my perspective, solo player. I'm a solo player, right? A Zerg running around a ball group, spamming regen, spamming AoE heals and everything, they won't notice the difference between 10% less healing. A solo player who tries to 1vx there, it hurts him way more. Another thing for the Zerglings, when we talk about Zergs versus small scale, was one thing which may be overlooked by a lot of people, right? But I think this will make a huge difference. Where is it? Where were the chains? Let me just check crafting ingredients. New motors, furnishings, blah blah blah, and then it comes. Where is it? Where is it? New achievements, new dice. There we go. This one. I hate it. Timidity, or however you pronounce it. You can craft potions which reduce the ultimate points. They don't even slow down the ultimate generation. It straight out reduces ultimate points. You know, Zerg and Cyrodiil, you have your bow spammers. Let one of the bow spammers equip a poison with this effect. Yeah, it will be expensive, you think? Yeah, but think about it, you use it as poisons, right? With one ingredient you can craft 16 poisons, so it's not as expensive as if you would craft it as a potion, where you get only 4 potions out of one ingredient, right? Yeah. But this, for solo players, this is hell. You have to rely on your ultimate charge. You need to get your ultimates up to be defensive or to have the burst ready at the right moment, right? When your ultimate is reduced, your healing is reduced, Zergs are just gonna dominate, right? And the only Zerg nerf which I saw in this whole patch notes was the change to Barrier, where Barrier got 50% more ult cost. Duh. I mean... That's just nothing. Yeah. So I have to say I'm slightly worried. I mean, I don't mind this. This is nice. You got now tri-stat regen, which you could apply if you want to. This is nice. Opens some more fury crafting. Maybe helps out some hybrid builds, even though hybrid builds aren't a thing. But they pushed some other stuff for hybrid builds. So maybe someone finds finally a combination to make a hybrid build work. That's great. Yeah. As I said, Vampire, probably everyone will remove Vampire if it stays in with this cost reduction and the passives aren't as useful. Yeah. I think Vampire won. But everyone will become werewolf, basically. Two Age Masters no longer e-capped, but too bad that it doesn't now. It doesn't fucking lag here. I mean, yeah, imagine cleave bombing, right? Could just cleave bomb there. Yeah, but I think Maelstrom weapon is the Maelstrom two-hander is more attractive now with the pleat, right? Now that it counts as a pleat, you can make a cheese pleat build around it, so that's nice, I guess. And werewolf. Werewolf will be bonkers. And especially with this pen set. Let me have another look. I mean, how do they even think in which mindset is this acceptable? Where is it? In which world is this acceptable? This has to be a typo, right? They mean they have 1-3 too much there, 1-5 too much, right? 14k spell and physical penetration against off-balance enemies. And werewolf have war, which sets an enemy off-balance for 7 seconds. I have no words. Yeah. Okay, but those were the patch notes, basically, right? So, yeah, done with this. Any questions left? Any ideas? Anything I missed or something? Otherwise, I would call it a day with the patch notes, and I will probably also end my stream, by the way. It's gotten already late. I didn't know this would take so long to go through these patch notes. They definitely delivered their 50 pages.